In the rest of this lesson, we're gonna look at Eclipse and try to get more familiar with Eclipse in a hands-on manner through a demo. In the demo, we will cover some of the basic aspects of Eclipse, like how to run Eclipse, how to select a workspace, how to create a project, how to create a class within the project, and so on. We'll also cover some more advanced aspects like how to create builders, run your projects within Eclipse, and how to use the Eclipse debugger. So let's get to the demo. So let's start Eclipse. So Eclipse is going to ask me for the location of my workspace. And in this case, I see that I selected a suitable directory. And you can also use that checkbox on the left to avoid Eclipse for asking you again about where to put the workspace. And the workspace is basically the place, the directory, where Eclipse will place all of your projects. So now when you start Eclipse, if it's the first time, you might get this welcome screen. It's not going to happen again on subsequent execution. But I just wanted to make sure that I covered all the bases. And so what you want to do here is to basically go to the Java perspective, which you can do by clicking over there, or you can also use the menus. So in this case, we will have to go to Window, Open Perspective, and if the perspective is not here, you'll have to click on Other, and at this point, you can click on Java Perspective. Then you click OK. And the perspective is basically the visual workspace where you will be operating. So after we selected perspective, we can actually close the welcome screen. And here you see that you have these different areas. And on the left, you have the package explorer. This is the area where your packages will be. You got a task list and an outline on the right, which we'll cover later. And then you have underneath at the bottom, problems, Java doc, and declaration views. And we will see some of these views in actions later. And here in the center, you have the area which is called the code editor, which is where you'll be writing, editing, and modifying basically your code. This is where most of the action takes place. So let's start by creating a Java project. And to do that, we can either use a context menu, or you can just use the menu, select new Java project. You will be greeted by this wizard. And at this point in the wizard, you can select the name of your project. I'm just going to call it a very simple way, my project. Then I'm going to use the default location for the project. As you can see, it will be placed in the workspace that I selected before. I'm going to also use the default Java runtime environment, which is Java 1.7 in this case. I'm going to keep the selected default layout, and then I'm going to go to the next step. Here, we're first presented with the location of the source code for our project. The default is a directory src in my project, and for the output file, the directory bin. We're not going to change that. Here, in case you need other projects to build your own, then you can specify them here. Here we are building a simple project, so there's no need for that. And here we can specify which libraries our project requires. As you can see, the Java library is already specified, and you can also add other jars, which can even be external jars. And finally, this is the tab that allows you to specify which part of your project, so how your project will be exported. So let's not worry about that for now. Let's click Finish. And as you can see here on the Package Explorer, my project appeared. So now we can open the project by clicking on the triangle right next to it. And as you can see, there is the SRC directory where my source code will go. And there's also an indication that we are using the JRE, so that the Java System Library within our project. And this is just for people who are interested in what happens under the hood. So if you don't care about that, you can just skip this part. So basically here, I'm showing you how we can go to the directory where the project was created. We can see the bin and SRC directories. And there's also some other files here that you can see, these dot files that you don't normally see. And those are kind of bookkeeping files. So these are files that contain information about your project and that are created automatically by Eclipse. And for example, we'll have various indication about the configuration of the project, some settings, and the class path for the project. And as I said, you don't have to worry about this if you just want to go Eclipse, you're never going to mess with the command line.